Hello students, today in this lecture we are going to take a topic from class 12, matrices, in which in the last lecture we have taken symmetric and skew-symmetric matrices. Now in this lecture we will be going to take properties of symmetric and skew-symmetric matrices. Along with this we will be going to take few theorems also. So till now what we have studied is symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix means when a matrix, if you take transpose of the matrix, it is equal to the same matrix A. And if I say about skew-symmetric, skew-symmetric matrix means transpose of a matrix is minus of A. So this was the last topic that we have already taken, that is about the symmetric and skew-symmetric matrix. Now we are going to take one theorem that I think I have also taken in the previous lecture, that is theorem number 1. First theorem is all the diagonal elements of a skew symmetric matrix are zero. This is the theorem, and this we have already taken because I have to take the next particular theorem. For that we need to prove this theorem again. That is, if I take a skew symmetric matrix, we know about skew symmetric matrix means A transpose is equal to minus of A. If I go for the elements, matrix A is having the element Aij, so transpose will be Aji will be equal to minus of Aij. So for all the elements we are going to take in this way only, but for diagonal elements, where I is equal to J, it becomes Aii is equal to minus Aii, which becomes 2Aii is equal to 0. And now we can see, this gives you the clear indication that here we can say this thing, that diagonal elements are 0. So this was the proof for the theorem, which is having the statement that all the diagonal elements are 0. Okay, so I'm rubbing this one and I'm going for the second theorem. Second theorem is very important, that is theorem number 2. If A is a square matrix, then A plus A transpose, that is for any square matrix A, number 1, A plus A transpose is always symmetric, and A minus A transpose is skew symmetric. Clear? So this is the theorem, which is very important, and we need to have the proof also. So for the proof, here they are saying any square matrix. So if I go with the matrix A plus A dash, let the sum be denoted by B. If you have to prove that the sum of a matrix and its transpose is symmetric, so we have to check their transpose. That is, transpose of any matrix, if it is coming the same, then only we can say it is symmetric. So I am going to take transpose. So this implies B transpose becomes A plus A transpose whole transpose. And we have studied in the properties of transpose that transpose is distributive. This becomes A transpose plus A transpose of the transpose matrix. So this becomes A dash. Transpose of a transpose matrix is same A. as addition is commutative, we can write this one as a plus a dash, and this becomes only b. So we are getting b transpose is equal to b. So this implies b means a plus a dash is symmetric matrix. In the same way, if you go with the other part, that is, let a and a dash be denoted as c. Let us take it like that. And again, to check that whether it is symmetric or skew symmetric, because no, sorry, here we are going to take minus. So let us write this one as c. We are going to take again the transpose. This implies it becomes a minus a transpose whole transpose. It is distributive. A transpose, transpose ka transpose. दो बार ट्रांसपोज लोगे तो मैट्रिक्स वही रहती है. ये हो जाएगा ए ट्रांसपोज माइनस ए. एडिशन इज कॉम्यूटेटिव. हियर इफ यू आर सेइंग दैट माइनस, आई एम गोइंग टू राइट माइनस ए फर्स्ट और उसके बाद लिखा हमने ट्रांसपोज. दोनों में माइनस कॉमन है, माइनस कॉमन लिया, ये बन गया ए माइनस ए ट्रांसपोज. इसे कहते हैं माइनस सी. तो हमारे पास क्या आ रहा है, हमारे पास रिजल्ट आ रहा है सी ट्रांसपोज इज इक्वल टू माइनस सी. इफ ट्रांसपोज ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स इज इक्वल टू माइनस ऑफ ए, transpose of a matrix is equal to minus of the matrix, it is skew symmetric. So here we can say this implies, yeah, therefore we can write C means A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix.